please close your eyes with me. Winter has gone, spring is coming, and also the summer. So soon we will head to the beach. And you probably remember from last year, when you were sitting on the beach with your friends, lazy, in the sand, had some nice drinks, talking, chatting, ordering some food, playing with the sand through your hands. And as always, you look at the sea. And you see the fish happily jumping from the sea. So happy. And the birds calling from the skies. So happy. You may open your eyes. That was me also 9 years ago, happy sitting on the beach, looking at the sunset. It was a brilliant day in September 2009. And while taking my last sip of rosé, I was heading home. And on top of the dunes, I live close to Bloemendaal and Zee, I looked back. And when I looked back, I actually saw this. Devastating place of trash. But I always thought that there comes these cleaners and they clean the beach with the big bulldozers. But waiting there, when the tide came up, I actually saw that all the plastic, or most of the plastic, actually went into the sea, into the ocean. And I never realized this. So I questioned myself, what's happening to this? And doing some research, I found out that over 800 million kilos of plastic is entering our ocean every day. Every year. Which is already a lot every year, but imagine every day. It's really a lot of plastic. And it's really the thing that I found it so stupid, that I was walking on this beach and I thought, why doesn't everybody take this stuff with them? But to comprehend this big number, I put it into a figure to make it more clear to you. Of course, you know the weight of the Titanic, 175 times. This weight of the Titanic every year enters into the ocean. Probably doesn't say you anything, the weight of the Titanic. So, but it's more than 4 million cars every year on trash amounts entering our oceans. And you can imagine that all this plastic actually slowly biodegrades into the ocean. Yeah, it's getting into smaller particles and it's becoming one with the ocean. The so-called plastic soup. And yes, we do eat from the ocean. And all these fishes are eating from the ocean, and the birds in the sky are also eating from the ocean. So they do eat plastic, and we do eat this plastic. Enough trash talk. Now we're going to the fun way. I wanted to create change. This little guy on the beach, on the dunes, looking at all this trash with this enormous, gigantic failure, actually, of the world what we are creating with plastic. I want to change it. And I discovered that most of the people actually are willing to change. I started asking questions. Why are we drinking mineral water, for instance, in the Netherlands, while tap water is coming straight from our faucet? And people actually said, it's actually a vehicle to transport my water, my tap water. So I kept this in the back of my mind. But how persuade people from one to the other? So 9 years ago, flash mobs were very in. So I created a flash mob that time. And in Utrecht, Amsterdam, and in Haarlem, more than 500 people did this amazing dance all together. And I can tell you, I think 95% of the people who were there had no clue why they were there, except for the fun part, to be part of a flash mob. But the idea was that everybody at the end of the show delivered their PET bottle to us and then will change their lifestyle. That was the original idea. But I think most of the people came for fun, which was good, because the next day and the days after, people starting to watch the video which we made on YouTube. And back then, 70,000 hits in 1 month was a lot, and that's what we made. So people then started to think, ah, that's why I was here. But the most important thing is that we wanted to create a change. So move from a bad habit to a sustainable solution. To a sustainable solution. That's the most important thing what I want to do. But still, I felt very small and how we can create change. What I did, I initiated a design competition because Dutch designers, they have a brilliant taste to make the perfect bottle for tap water. Like 20 years ago, Spa, Evian, all the big water bottle brands, they persuaded us to move from sustainable water glass at home to a PET bottle because you will dry out between Beeldhoven and Amsterdam, of course, if you don't have your bottle with you. So how to persuade the people is to make something which is a little bit alike, but it's much more clever. So out of this competition came this beautiful design, at least it was the original design from the bottle, made by alumni from the Technical University in Delft. And I was very happy with this design because it turned out to be this very handy thing with exactly the same diameter, 2.2 centimeters, that the water flows exactly in the same smooth direction as from a mineral water bottle. So you get the same sensation. On the side, we have the nice Dopper logo, which gives the same kind of feeling that the bottle doesn't slip away. And the nice thing is that you can use it also as a cup at the same time. And Rinke, the designer, he actually made this bottle because he wanted to make it sustainable, which you can make it easy to clean. So now with the two wide openings, goes easy into dishwasher, and you can rinse it with a brush. But why Rinke won this competition? The most important thing is that I want to create change and let people know why we are creating change. We wanted to make tap water important again. We wanted to put water on a pedestal, so make tap water important again. So that's why it's such a unique design. How to persuade people that you're really going to use it. Some people like Adidas shoes, some people want to have Nikes, for everybody another color. Of course, we started with a very nice blue bottle, but we really made it a lifestyle product. A lifestyle product in different colors, which suits your outfit, in different materials. Now we have also stainless steel, in a big version and a small version. So for everybody, there is a bottle. There's no more excuse not to change. And you can take it everywhere. Everywhere where you want, you can take this bottle. And what we created as well was an app where you can find water tap stations all over the world. So no more excuse to buy it from a kiosk on the station. You just walk around the corner and you find your tap. Also, if you're on the run, we have a sports cap to go with it. So it makes life very easy. Important also for if you want to create change is to make your brand or the thing which you have very important. And how can you make it important to get awarded? So the first thing what we did was applying for the Red Dot Awards to make this bottle not a sports bottle, but make this bottle a design water bottle. So we got rewarded with the Red Dot Design Awards, which really is a prestige prize internationally. So you get known as a design bottle. We got the Game Changer Awards. We got the Marketing Awards. We got the Green Product Awards. And the Best of the World Overall Awards from B Corp. So all these prizes will really help to build the brand and make it bigger if you get rewarded. And you only get rewarded if you start asking for rewards. So that's the thing what you have to do. So if you build up some company, some brand, you really try to pick up every competition, and you will not win every competition because we lost also quite some competition, but these are the ones we won. We also, and that's what I found is very important, a lot of people thought, okay, let's make something from recycled material. Of course, it sounds very logic, but we don't want to have the source of recycled material. So we were the first water bottle to become cradle-to-cradle certified, which means after the lifespan of Dopper, we want to have the bottle back and we will recycle it again in the same Dopper bottle. So we feel responsible for our products, what we put in the world. That's very important. And Dopper is a social enterprise. What does it mean, a social enterprise? You take care of the world. You think about the world, you want to change it, and you take care of it. When I started, it was really an NGO thought. So I wanted to create a movement. But then there came a bottle. And if you have responsible, you have to have a limited company. But how does it all suit together? It's really hard. But we were part of the cradle to cradle process, and actually they tipped us, yeah, it's nice you have a limited company, but how do you see your company? And they said how they felt, how they see it. You're actually using business as a force for good. You're selling a product, but by selling the product, you were really creating change. Which was really important to me, because I thought, okay, I want to be on the soft side to change. On the other hand, I want to make money, because I want to grow the company to make more impact. But it's really hard in the Netherlands if you say I'm doing good and earning money at the same time. But being a social enterprise, it actually says it all. You're socially doing good, and an enterprise, you want to make money to get better and better every year and make more impact every year. To make it more complete for Dopper, it's a vehicle to drink tap water from. But at the moment, there is also 900 million people in the world. They don't have access to safe drinking water. So an extra what we did to make the circle round is to give 5% from our net proceeds. So not from our profit, it's from our net proceeds. It's part of our daily business. We're giving and donating to water projects in Nepal. And in Nepal, we are working together with the local community to create change for the rest of their life. So it's not emergency help. It's really a change for the rest of their lives. They make the water pipes, the drilling for the wells, the tap waters themselves, the taps themselves. They make it all themselves, so they can maintain it also year after year, and it's not going away after a few years. But we do more with this money, what we donate. We want to encourage students. So here you are in the room to create the same change on plastic reduction and on better water quality. So if you do have to finish a thesis, or if you do have to do some extra projects for school, please come to us. We have some grants to give out to help to make these projects possible. And also, we first started with an Olympian here, Olympic sailor. I also have an Olympic dream. Already all my life, I want to do top sports. I didn't make it to the Olympic Games, but I made it in another way. I thought, I want to have this stage on the Olympic Games to change the world and show the people in the world that we have to create change. So what we did with Dopper is we created a statue during the Olympic Games 2 years ago already. And it's called the Plastic Madonna. And what we thought, how we can do it is by asking the local community to gather a lot of PET bottles, a lot of plastic water bottles, and then we're going to make a statue which is related to Rio, because there were the Olympic Games. This is Madonna breastfeeding her baby child Jesus, and the metaphor is that if we keep on polluting our food chain, so giving it to our children, this small baby Jesus will never be this big Jesus high on the mountain in Rio. That was our metaphor. And we started 1 year prior to the Olympic Games to do this collecting of the bottles and making the statue. And also the local government, they really liked what we did. And my gold medal during the Olympic Games was this. We created the Olympic rings on Copacabana Beach, made out of recycled materials only. And it's the most photographed picture in Rio. So in that way, we created change. Of course, we had signs around, so people could read what we were doing there. And the second person on the left, the mayor of Rio, was even there to open the rings. It was really important for us, and it really inspired us to continue making actually more and more art pieces. So, 15th of June, you're all welcome in New York. please come along. We're going to create a bridge from the Netherlands to the US. So that some people did a few hundred years ago, but we want to do it again. We create a bridge out of 25,000 water bottles, and you really can walk over it, and when you're on it, you can start fishing for plastic solutions, because we're going to create a river of plastic water bottles, and all in these water bottles we put messages. Messages how you can change your lifestyle and behavior on single-use plastic. So when you're over it, over the bridge, you step to in a world of plastic-free, the plastic-free world, actually. So that is how we want to create change. You're all welcome. 15th of June, and we want to ask end of next year and in the summer. So you have a whole year to come along in the US to have a look. As I said, we want to create a PET-free world. That's the material made out of the plastic water bottles. And how to do it? Of course, every individual is important to make this change. But it's also important to ask companies and schools, universities, sports clubs, everybody to join actually a pet-free movement to create a pet-free world. So please join. I saw during the break you have a lot to learn still on single-use plastic. So please sign the pledge and step into a pet-free world and be part of the change and be the change for yourself. But how? How can you create change? That's why we're here tonight and very inspiring speakers before me. How to make this difference? I think for all of you, if you create your own mission in life, so your goal where you want to go, and you do this with a meaning, we all can create this change. And why I'm telling you all this, that's very important for me, of course. Because I think at the end we all share the same dream. At least after tonight, after seeing the single-use plastic cups in the break, it will not happen again after this, I think. We will share the same dream all together. We want to have pristine beaches at the end. We want to have crystal clear water and tap water for everybody. Thank you very much.